I've been wanting to make this video for a while now, but I wasn't sure when I was going to make it or how exactly I wanted to structure the video, but in very exciting and extremely overdue news, my boyfriend and I adopted another cat. This is really overdue because we actually adopted her in March of this year, so we've already had her for 6 months. We adopted her, which was actually not the initial plan because I was actually hoping to adopt a male kitten, but we ended up with our sweet baby girl instead. I'll go much more into detail about Fiora, but I wanted to start off by talking about Aslan because he is my sweet and precious baby boy and I love him so much. If you've watched my videos before, you probably know I have a big orange boy named Aslan. My boyfriend, Steven, and I actually adopted him on Valentine's Day in 2017, which had no correlation with the holiday at all, that's just how it ended up happening. But at the time, I was living with my parents, who hadn't had cats since I was probably around 14 or 15. But I had fallen in love with Steven's family cat, and that made me really want a cat of my own. My parents had two small dogs at the time, so I figured it wouldn't be the worst combination of animals. So after much, much persuasion and many trips to our local humane society, I finally convinced my mom to let me adopt a cat. I really wanted a female cat because the cats I had grown up with were all male, so anytime we went to a local shelter, that was by far my main focus. My mom was hoping I would be getting a kitten, just because you never know what kind of history you're getting into when it comes to adopting an adult cat, but that didn't steer me away at all because I was far more interested in adopting an adult because they already have so much established personality. So as a whole, I was just drawn to the individual cats based off of how they acted versus kittens, just kind of cute. Not that kittens don't have any personality, but adult cats definitely have a lot more when you're looking at them at a shelter. But Steve and I were pretty much going to the shelter on a weekly basis to visit the kitties, and eventually we stumbled upon my sweet baby boy. It's kind of funny because at first I actually had no interest in Aslan at all. He didn't even spark my interest, even remotely, because he was this big orange cat and he had mad resting bitch face. And he looked very intimidating and kind of mean, to be honest, but Steven showed interest in him and we found out he was an absolute sweetheart and he loved affection and he had the most precious tiny, tiny little voice. Like, it's so fun seeing a big intimidating cat with such a small and little cute voice, but we instantly fell in love with him. My mom was still on the boat of wanting me to get a kitten, so it took a couple of weeks of sending her pictures of him and eventually just having her go to the shelter with me to see him until she finally agreed that we could adopt him. And then we were all set. Thankfully, no one else adopted him in that time frame though, because it was genuinely a 2 week period of when we first met him versus when we actually adopted him. So I'm very grateful for that. And Aslan was also the name that they had given him at the shelter. We decided to keep it because it was super fitting for him. And this was also really convenient for me too, because I hadn't even begun to really think of names for a male cat. And I'm also just really bad at making a decision like naming a pet. So that worked very well in my favor. And when we adopted him, he was estimated to be 2 years old, so right now he's 5. Every year we throw a little birthday party for him and he kind of hates it, but he gets wet food out of it, so he's winning in the end. And in taking him home, it definitely took a while for him to open up and start showing his true personality, because as we found out, he's actually a really, really shy and withdrawn cat, but ooh, he's the sweetest boy ever. He's just very shy. It takes him a while to get used to a new environment, but he's such an angel. He's such a good cat, and I love him so, so much. He's a big lazy boy who loves lounging around and relaxing, and he's also huge on being a lab cat. And thank God, because it's so nice having a lab cat, he'll actually follow me or Steven around the house when we're doing stuff, and he just wants to be around us as a whole. And it's just, it's very nice having a little companion to hang out with whenever we're doing stuff. And ever since Steven and I moved in together, he's really been living his best life. Once we moved into an apartment, it became very apparent that Aslan does not like dogs, because once he adjusted to the new environment, he's been so much more comfortable here compared to living at my parents' house. He got along with the dogs just fine, but he would antagonize dogs and vice versa, and it was just kind of a mess, but he's just lounging all the time and his belly's always out and exposed and he just seems a lot more comfortable. So I'm very happy for him to be in this environment because he seems a lot happier than he was at my parents' house. Not by any means was he unhappy, because obviously I would not have kept him if he was like stressed out in the environment, but it's just really nice to see him constantly like super relaxed and having the time of his life because he deserves the world. I love him so much. but while he was truly living his best life being an only child, I was plotting in the background to ruin his life by bringing another cat into the mix, and then came Fiora. So I never realistically imagined getting a second cat because I was not sure how Aslan liked other cats, but my best friend actually has 3 cats, and after watching how well her cats got along together, I started getting real bad cat fever again. My friend was comfortable bringing one of her cats over to see how Aslan would react to him, which, first and foremost, you never want to introduce cats to each other right off the bat like that, but it was just kind of our only option for the specific situation of just seeing how Aslan would react. Like I said, I would never recommend introducing cats like that. It was just very situational, and this was our only chance because, worst case scenario, we adopted a cat, Aslan hated other cats, and we'd have to return that cat. So I just kind of wanted a base reaction to go off of, but thankfully, it honestly went leagues better than I ever could have imagined. Aslan was so good with her cat Boris, and he showed no signs of aggression or being territorial or anything. He was more than anything very curious about checking out the other cat, so that was a big green light for me and Steven to start looking at other cats. I was pretty glad with the time frame of everything because spring was coming, which meant kitten season, and while I definitely preferred the idea of adopting an adult cat for several reasons, I figured we would be better off adopting a kitten because in my mind, worst case scenario was adopting another adult cat who would physically harm Aslan, and that would just be like nightmare situation. So I figured getting a kitten would be playing it safe because it wouldn't have presumably any aggression or bad behaviors towards other cats. So that's what we were kind of leaning towards. We also wanted to get a male kitten because Dr. Google told me that male cats tend to get along better with a male versus a male with a female, so we were definitely on the lookout for a male kitten. And then came sweet, sweet pandemic, which made the process of adopting a cat a lot harder through shelters, understandably, but pretty much every shelter in the area wasn't open for regular walk-ins where you can just come in and see the cats they have available. Instead, they wanted you to schedule an appointment to meet a specific cat. And of course, this is very understandable. The less traffic, the better in this situation, but after several weeks of stalking the websites of literally every single shelter in the area multiple times a day, I saw a picture of a beautiful cat named Gigi, and tragically, she was a girl. Honestly, I'm kind of ashamed to say that I was pretty desperate after nearly a month of looking for a cat, and at this point we had already had a situation where we were on the way to adopt a cat, but it turned out someone already adopted him like a day prior, but the shelter just didn't update their website, which was extremely upsetting and really stupid. Like, you'd think that shelters, all shelters, everywhere, would update that kind of information literally right away, but whatever, I digress. So even though this cat was a girl, she was absolutely gorgeous, so we made an appointment to meet her, and in a cursed turn of events, when we got there for our appointment, someone else was actually meeting her, and we had to wait almost half an hour for them to be done. And at one point, one of the staff there asked for her paperwork, so Steven and I were like screaming internally because we thought they were adopting her. But pretty much at the last minute, I guess they had found another cat that looked very similar to one that they had previously, so they decided to adopt him instead. And thank God, because I was going to have a meltdown if they adopted her, because the shelter didn't let us know someone else was going to see her, which, again, kind of dumb that this wasn't communicated. But thankfully there was no harm there, but it was just like, oh my gosh. But Steven and I finally got to see the cat, and she was so affectionate and such a sweet little girl. They let us go into a small room with her to meet her, and we instantly fell in love with her. The only thing we were turned off from was that she hissed over like everything, which is so different from Aslan because he's the kind of cat who hisses only if he's really upset, but we wanted to get her really bad, so we just ended up adopting her, and thankfully, I can happily say that the habit of hissing has completely gone away. I think it was just her, like, stress response to being in a, like, environment she's not comfortable with. She was just a hissy girl at the shelter, but she doesn't do that anymore, which is really nice. But it took us a few days to finally come up with a name for her because neither of us were really a fan of the name Gigi, but we ended up deciding to name her Fiora after a character from Xenoblade Chronicles, which is Steven's favorite game. One of our bathrooms is attached to our laundry room, which makes a very decently sized area, so we kept Fiora in there for the first week or two to get accustomed to the new environment before introducing her to Aslan. and we were told by the shelter that she had been around other cats before and that she did like other cats, but as soon as she saw Aslan for the first time, she became fairly aggressive and upset. So since then, it's just been a weird adjusting period, but they coexist very well, and we are finally in the position where we can leave them at home together, and Steve and I aren't home. Thankfully, they don't fight at all, like they've never actually fought. They just play with each other, but it's always like one wants to play, the other one doesn't want to play, but it's never like one constantly ganging up on the other. It's very split, so it's very nice. They're not buddy-buddy where they cuddle or anything like that, but they get along really well, and they're doing so much better than when we first got them. Fiora's personality is also so different from Aslan's. Aslan's a very shy and lazy cat, but Fiora is super adventurous and playful, and literally everything she does is like triple speed at which Aslan works. It's really funny. Aslan seems like the kind of cat who's really genuinely smart and thinks things through, but Fiora, on the other hand, just seems like she has elevator music playing in her head at like 4x speed, and that's all that's happening in her brain at any point in time. And I say this with as much love as possible because I'm so happy we adopted her and I love her so much. She's just a little crazy, but she's also really affectionate and she's insanely gentle. Like, she has not once tried to bite or swat at us, even if we're really annoying her or if she's really upset with us for trimming her nails, which she throws an absolute tantrum when you trim her nails. It's kind of funny, but it's like, oh my gosh, girl. But Aslan's the kind of cat where if you're bothering him, he will be very quick to biting you or scratching you without any warning. But Fiora's the complete opposite in the sense that, like, she will never do anything to hurt you. But she's super playful and likes literally any toy you give her, which is such a fun change from Aslan because I have spent so much money buying things for Aslan that he just could not care less about. Fiora actually has only shown up in one of my other videos, which she did show up, but it was for a very insignificant time frame because she pretty much just ran across my desk for a few frames and then bailed. I'll try to show her off more in future videos if I can, but she's really just not the kind of cat who will lay down on my desk to hang out with me for a few hours like Aslan does. She's pretty much just constantly moving around and doing something, so whenever she does come onto my desk when I'm working, it tends to make it a little chaotic. But Aslan and Fiora are both such sweet cats. I'm really grateful to have their companionship in my life because they're so sweet and I love them so much. They're basically my children and I absolutely would kill for them. I used to think I was a dog person growing up, but having cats has really just taught me that I love all animals. Steven and I really want to get a dog eventually, but for the time being, we are more than content having our sweet little cats. And thank you guys so much for making it this far into the video. I don't know if you guys necessarily had any questions or anything about either Aslan or Fiora, but if you do, feel free to leave them below and I'll try to respond as soon as I can. I know Fiora was a surprise. I was just kind of saving her not to post on Instagram or anything, but here she is. And I think it's also worth mentioning that I reopened my Patreon page as well. I currently only have one tier that's kind of just a tip jar, but if you're interested, a link will be in the description box below. It's kind of a weird place to plug it, but I'm pretty sure I'll mention it more in future videos. And thank you so much to everyone who has already pledged to my Patreon. I really appreciate it. You guys are so kind and so sweet, and I really appreciate it. And thank you guys so much for watching. It warms my heart when people get excited about seeing footage of Aslan in videos because he really is such an insanely large source of happiness in my life, and I love sharing pictures and videos of him. I'll also try to include footage of Fiora where I can too, because I'm sure you guys will love her just as much. But thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.